too.
You are a hard one, aren't you?
Oh, I can be soft on the right occasion. Look, what did you expect me to do? Burst into tears and beg you to forgive me? Isn't that what you really came in here for, Mrs. Haynes?
Not after seeing you. You're even more typical than I dared hope.
Well, honey, that goes double. Now, look, get this. I'd break up your snug little roost if I could, but I don't stand a chance. Oh, don't think it's because your husband isn't crazy about me. It's because he's the kind that lets that old-fashioned sentiment put the Indian sign on him, and that's all.
I'm glad you understand the strength of sentiment, Miss Allen, because its beauty is something you'll never know.
This happens to be my room, Mrs. Haynes.
It's yours, yes, for the time being, like everything else you've got. May I suggest if you're dressing to please Stephen, not that one. He doesn't like such obvious effects.
Thanks for the tip. But when anything I wear doesn't please Stephen, I take it off.
Hey there, movie gang and vintage Hollywood aficionados. Welcome back to Lights, Camera, Classics, the show where we dive deep into the golden age of Hollywood and unearth some hidden gems. I'm your host, Movie Man Gary, and today we're shining the spotlight on one of Tinseltown's most iconic and fascinating stars, Joan Crawford. Joan Crawford, a name synonymous with classic Hollywood glamour, fierce determination, and unforgettable performances. With a career that spanned over five decades, Joan went from silent film star to reigning queen of MGM, and finally to a legendary icon whose influence is still felt today. You might recognize her from her Oscar-winning role in Mildred Pierce, or her unforgettable performances in films like Whatever Happened to Baby Jane, Grand Hotel, and Possessed.
I thought I'd lost you.
David, my name isn't David, lady.
Today, we're buzzing about a film from the golden age of Hollywood that you might not have heard of, but absolutely need to see. Queen Bee hit theaters in 1955, and let me tell you, it's a juicy, dramatic masterpiece that'll have you hooked from the very first frame. But before we get into why this movie is a must-watch, let's talk a bit about its star, Joan Crawford. If you're not familiar with Joan, imagine a mix of Meryl Streep's acting prowess and Beyoncé's commanding presence. She was a force to be reckoned with, both on and off the screen. By the time Queen Bee was made, Crawford was already an established Hollywood icon, known for her intense and often controversial roles. In this film, she plays Eva Phillips, the ultimate Queen Bee of a Southern mansion. Eva is manipulative, glamorous, and has a sting sharper than any bee you've ever encountered. The plot revolves around Eva's toxic influence over her family and friends. Think of her as the original Regina George from Mean Girls, but with a bit more sophistication and a lot more venom.
And it's got the cutest kitchen, Jen, with an open fireplace. Right here, see? Of course, the floors are old and they've got cracks in them so wide that you can just practically see right through them. It used to be the garçonnière, what they call the bachelor's house. Every plantation had one for overnight gentlemen callers. Well, Judd says that he feels so wicked taking a girl to the bachelor's house, and I told him that if he...
Go on. It's such a pretty thought.
I forgot what I was saying.
You do forget things, don't you, Carol? I'm sorry about this afternoon. But I was upset about something. I'm not upset anymore. Please forgive me. Carol, I'm interested in you, and after all, I am fond of you and want you to be happy. And even though it hurts me terribly, I think we should talk about you and Judd.
What about us?
Oh, Carol, you're so good. It's hard for you to imagine that others aren't... Well, as nice as you are. I'd like to prepare you, that's all, for anything you might hear about Judd.
Eva, don't.
Why, Jennifer, I think you've found out. How clever of you, and so quickly, too. You'll have to tell me how you knew, some other time, of course.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about men. I know men and I know Judd.
You know your men.
Any man's my man if I want it that way.
Not Judd.
Judd's like other men, no better, no worse.
Are you trying to tell me Judd's been carrying on some cheap affair I don't know about? Is that it?
Ask him.
Do you think I'll go running to him with something as stupid as this? Do you think I'll let you spoil things for us at the last minute?
Ask him.
No, I won't ask him. I won't go to him with your lies.
I wouldn't lie to you about something as important as this.
Well, then, if it's true, tell me who it is.
Who do you think?
The film dives deep into themes of power, control, and a dark side of human nature, themes that are still incredibly relevant today. Now, one of the reasons I love Queen Bee is because it's not just about the drama, although trust me, there's plenty of that. It's about the incredible performances. Joan Crawford delivers every line with such intensity, it's like she's daring you to look away. Her co-stars, including Barry Solomon and Betsy Palmer, do a fantastic job holding their own, but make no mistake, this is Joan's show.
I'm determined to drag myself to your party. Oh, you really think I should? Well, of course, if you don't want me. All right. Then I'll go back to bed. All right. Bye now. Now I can stay home and enjoy your company. Aren't I wicked?
Yes, as a matter of fact, you are.
Watching Queen Bee feels like a masterclass in acting. Crawford's portrayal of Eva is chilling and mesmerizing. She embodies a character that's both captivating and terrifying, which keeps you on the edge of your seat the entire time. And the fashion, oh my goodness, the fashion. Joan Crawford's wardrobe in this film is stunning, giving us all those vintage glam vibes that are so in right now. The film was directed by Ranala MacDougall, who does an amazing job of creating a tense, almost claustrophobic atmosphere. The mansion, where most of the story unfolds, feels like a character in itself, grand yet stifling, much like Eva's presence. Queen Bee is one of those films that might not be on everyone's radar, but it totally should be.
I've been discussing things with Carol and Judd. I've made a decision.
Really? A whole decision all by yourself?
I don't intend to argue with you. I've told them I don't believe in long engagements.
Well, I can't very well argue against that. We didn't have a long engagement, and look how idyllic we are.
Exactly. They're willing to get married immediately, and I've asked them to do so.
I'm very happy for both of them. Thrilled, in fact.
We knew we could count on your blessing.
There's just one little thing. I know it sounds terrible, but with everything happening so quickly, won't people wonder and talk? People will talk, you know. Without reason, of course. There isn't any reason, is there?
No, Eva. Not the way you mean. This may come as a surprise to you, but the only reason we're getting married is because we love each other.
Just thought I'd ask.
It's a fascinating look at mid-20th century cinema and a showcase of Joan Crawford's incredible talent. Plus, it's a great pick for a movie night if you're in the mood for some classic drama with a side of vintage style.
Now you can go back to your drinking. It'll make you feel more at home.
Oh, Eva.
You should have been here. Beauty's been making decisions all by himself about Carol and Judd. They're getting married right away.
Oh, that's wonderful. I was hoping they wouldn't wait. Oh, I'm so happy for them. I don't know what that...
So next time you're scrolling through your streaming options or browsing your local vintage shop, keep an eye out for Queen Bee. Trust me, it's a buzzworthy classic that you won't want to miss. Thanks for joining me on this cinematic journey today. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you never miss an episode of Lights, Camera, Classics. Dive into the comments section and let me know your favorite Joan Crawford film or if there's another classic star you'd love to see featured. There's always a hidden gem waiting to be discovered in the world of classic cinema. Until next time, keep the popcorn popping and the movies rolling. And remember,
I'll be back.